just like that, just keep doing that.
The vestibular system is responsible for decoding any sort of movement, so head movement, when you're walking, and just sort of keeping the body balanced. But the primary responsibility is keeping vision steady during any type of head movement.
All right, perfect.
A lot of effects of vestibular loss have been measured in adults and very few have been measured in children. So we're looking at how well children who have vestibular loss can see when their head is stable and when their head is in motion. Typically, we see vestibular loss more often in children who have greater degrees of hearing loss, which is why we're studying children with cochlear implants, because they have a large degree of hearing loss, which is what's necessitating the cochlear implant.
We're gonna do a couple more. I'm gonna turn your head like this.
There are actually three different tests that we do. One is called the video head impulse test, and that is where the subjects will wear very tight-fitting goggles and we stand behind them and move their head very rapidly. Then we do something called the vestibular evoked myogenic potential, and that's where we put electrodes on the neck, under the eyes, and then they listen to loud clicking sounds while they either look up or lift their head. And then the last test is going to be the rotary chair test, where they sit in a chair in a darkened booth and then the chair just rotates back and forth. And all of those tests look at the vestibular system in a different way and let us know if it's functioning or not.
Stand like this, one foot in front of the other, right foot behind, and then your left foot in front.
After we determine if they have vestibular loss or not, then we put them through a functional assessment. First of all, just looking at how well he can maintain his balance. The purpose of that is to see if vestibular loss disrupts balance. Does it disrupt walking? Does it disrupt your ability to do more than one thing at a time? And then the last thing was looking at how well that affects how well you can see. So we were asking him to watch visual targets while he was sitting still, and then watching visual targets while he moves his head back and forth to see if there's disruptions in how well he can see.
That's perfect.
The overall goal is to determine whether or not we need to be paying attention to the vestibular system, particularly in kids with hearing loss. So much of habilitation is directed towards the hearing part, which addresses speech and language concerns, but there is some research showing that we need to be paying attention to the vestibular side of things, because disruptions in the way that we see during head movement can potentially affect academic performance. We're hoping that it generates awareness for, one, assessing for vestibular loss in children, and the second thing then is to get children enrolled in vestibular rehab programs. Our research then will eventually look at the outcomes of whether rehabilitation corrects some of the abnormalities that we see with vestibular loss.